The eyes are one of the most critical parts of an animated character. They really help add some emotion and personality and really bring the character to life. So what I've created here is a free example project that will show you four different techniques for creating the eyes. A lot of the differences are subtle between them, but depending on your style and your aesthetic and all of that, one of these might be the best fit for you. So this is a free downloadable project. Anyone can download it. The link's in the video description below. Feel free to take it apart, and we're gonna walk through each of these techniques in this video. So our first guy here on the left, basic eyes, the yellow guy here, he just has, you know, simple ovals with a pupil that's basically by default centered in the middle there. And as I look around, up, down, left, right, he's looking in those different directions. He also has a blink state. So when I blink my eyes, he is also very for a very short duration, showing a blinked closed eyelid state. Then next we've got off-centered eyes, this green guy here. So by default, his eyes are a little bit closer to his nose, right? They're not in the center of the circle. They're a little bit off-centered. And there's a special technique you have to do to make that work, and I'll show that in a little bit. The third one is large pupils, this blue girl over here. So this is like if you're doing an anime style character where the pupils are traditionally a little bit larger and are fitting in a more constrained eyeball space. And there's, again, some secrets and techniques to do that sort of thing. And she also has a blink state that's a cycle layers blink. So you notice it's a nice fluid three frame animated state when I'm blinking my eyes. And we'll talk about doing that as well. Finally, this last character is using eyelids. So this is in lieu of a blink state. So instead of doing blinks, you instead have a top and bottom eyelid. And as I'm moving my eyelids up and down in the kind of opening and closing them in the webcam, this character is also reacting to that and showing that as well. So let's dig into this. Let's go into rig mode. And the way I'm gonna do that is by double clicking eyes down here in the timeline. That's just a shortcut to get to that puppet in rig mode. All right, so here we see the setup of these four different heads. I see that I've got yellow, green, blue, and red. Each of these is their own group. And if you twirl them open, you'll see kind of all the different contents inside. I'm gonna do most of my explaining of how these characters were created in Photoshop, because that's where I originally created them. And I didn't really honestly do too much rigging, you know, in here in Character Animator. It just kind of automatically works if you name things the right way. So because this is called left eye, for example, you'll see it gets tagged over here in the tags panel as left eye, or, you know, the pupil or whatever you want. So, you know, you follow these conventions, things should just automatically work. But let's go and see the original Photoshop file of this. And I can do that by making sure the puppet is selected over here in my project panel, and then going to edit, edit original. All right, so I have my master artwork file here in Photoshop. So let's go through each of these characters and see what they're all about. Let's start with this basic eyes guy here. So if I twirl him open, I see that he's got a head group here, and inside a left eye, a right eye, a background sketch, and a background color. And then each of his eyes are these things here. These eyes are the simplest you're going to find. And that is in each eye group, left eye and right eye, I have a blink state, which is hidden by default, but this is the artwork that's gonna show up when I blink in the webcam. And then I have a pupil, this little black one right here, and the eyeball, which is the surrounding area. So in this basic setup, the way that it works is the eyeball is the kind of the confines of where the pupil is going to move around. So this pupil is never going to go, should never go outside of the eyeball. It's going to stay within that specific shape. And that's all there is to it. And because you keep the eye, the pupil centered inside the eye, it's going to look good no matter what, you know, direction you're looking in. And then, as I said, the blink state shows up when I blink. And actually what that's going to do is make the pupil and eyeball disappear at the same time. But because this is covering everything, you don't really notice that, but that's just what's happening behind the scenes. And that's why you kind of always want to have all your eye elements together in the same area. So when the blink shows up, you know, other parts of your face aren't disappearing or that sort of thing. Moving on to the next guy, off-center eyes over here. So let's close, twirl up yellow, and show us green now. So this guy is pretty similar, but you'll notice that the pupils are a little bit closer to the nose. They're not, you know, they're not in the middle here. Instead, I move them a little bit closer. And the way to deal with this sort of thing, if you just left these by themselves, some of the time it's going to look okay, actually, and, you know, the eyes will move around. But you do get into some weird states when you're looking diagonally or some other things, and the eyes aren't gonna know exactly how to compensate perfectly. So the way that I get around this issue, if I'm doing this type of look, is I'm actually gonna do a little bit of a trick where the white of the eyes, so this part here, is not actually the eyeball. This is not what I've tagged as the eyeball. Instead, I have this layer here, left eyeball, which I have at 1% opacity, but if I bring that up, you'll see this is the actual eyeball. This is the actual range, as we learned with the basic eyes, that the pupil is going to move around in. And so this is kind of a hidden layer that's showing up behind everything, but this is what's controlling that eye gaze process. So so you wanna keep it at 1%. If you leave it at zero, I think it doesn't work exactly right. So I always just keep it visible and at 1%, and that should work okay. And yeah, this does constrain yourself a little bit, so you're never gonna get the pupils moving all the way up to the corner like this. If I were to do that, I might make a trigger, you know, to make the eyes, you know, look all the way up like that. It's going to only stay within, you know, this eyeball range instead, whatever's tagged here. So that's a, you know, that's a small price you have to pay for this sort of thing, but I think it's okay. In this case, with the blink state, this is completely, you know, overtaking the eyes. This is what shows up when this character blinks. And so this is just a different blink treatment for this, and it'll show kind of how it's gonna hide everything else when you blink. All right, so moving over to our blue head over here with the large pupils. If you set this up normally, like we've done with these other ones, the pupils just, they wouldn't have a lot of room to move around in. So they either wouldn't move a lot, they would feel constrained by the eyeball, or they would feel, you know, they could move outside the eyeball, and that looks bad too. So the way that you get around this sort of thing is to actually kind of create a Halloween mask style treatment. So if I remove the eyes here, you'll see that the color, this foreground color layer that I have here, actually has holes inside of it, and so I can see through it. And what's happening there is, if I take these away and now show the eyes are actually full eyeballs and pupils and eyeballs that are showing up behind each of these, you know, behind this mask, and that allows them the mobility that they need to move around and look around without being constrained by the shape of the eyes. So if you're doing this sort of treatment, this is how I would go about it. Create, you know, these cutout Halloween mask style holes and then put the full eyeballs behind them instead. Now we noticed with this character, her blink state was a little bit different. So I made a lid group and then put a blink group inside of that. And then this is a 3-frame sequence that plays. So when I blink, it's gonna play frame 1, frame 2, and frame 3 to close the eyes. And then when I open my eyes again, it's gonna reverse the process. And that's because I've added cycle layers behavior to it. We've gone over this before. Check out the Puppet and Character Animator to see how this was done. But this just adds to a smoother blinking process that I've started adding to most of my characters, just because I think it looks a little bit nicer to do it, you know, smoothly like this instead of just swapping out artwork. And then finally, that brings us to our red guy over here. And the technique, the general technique is kind of the same as what we saw with the large pupils here, where I've got, you know, a cutout holes in his head here. But then the eyes below are actually interesting because they've got the eyeball, they've got the pupil, but then I've also added these eyelid bottom and eyelid top states. So when you do this, what's gonna happen is these are gonna be tracked, whatever you call eyelid top and bottom are gonna be tracked to your own actual eyelids. And so as I, you know, move my eyelids and kind of squint, these are also going to move up and down as well. And so this adds, this actually replaces the blink. You'll notice this character does not have a blink layer here because your eyelids are already moving. So if you have something called eyelid bottom and top, then it's gonna ignore the blink part of it. And it's just gonna say, this is the, you know, I'm tracking the eyelid movement instead. And then the viewer is just seeing, you know, everything behind this. So as the eyelids, you know, close, they're gonna see them move like this. So you wanna make sure you have enough room so you're not getting into a state where, you know, you start to see the whites of the eyes, that sort of thing. So make sure, you know, this could be a rectangle. This doesn't have to be, you know, this type of shape. It can be whatever you want, whatever fits the theme and styling of your character. So yeah, that's all there is to it. And then you bring it into Character Animator and look around, and your pupils should be moving, your blinks should be happening, or eyelids should be moving as you would expect. Now you have a ton of customization with all of this stuff, with the behaviors. I've added individual eye gaze and face behaviors for each of these faces, but if you're making your own puppet, you'd probably only see one of these for eye gaze and face. So for example, my yellow eyes over here, basic eyes, if I feel like they're moving around a little bit too much, I could open up my eye gaze behavior and change the camera strength parameter if I wanted it to be like 50% or something like that. Now you'll notice the pupils aren't going as far to the side, they're staying a little bit closer to the middle. And I could bring that down even further if I wanted to make the movement very, very, very subtle. Same with the eyelid controls on my red guy over here. So if I twirl open face red, one of these is called eyelid strength. So let's make this back to 100 and you'll see I get a lot more sensitivity over the eyes. I can really squint and really open up the eyes. Or I could make this a little bit further down. I think I had it at 50%, which isn't gonna close it all the way, but it gives it enough that you can kind of get that, you know, more squinted look. And I could bring this even further down to even make it a little bit more subtle. So even something like this adds a nice subtle effect to your character. It's, but you have a lot of options about how, you know, how expressive that is. So yeah, that's a basic overview of the eyes. We get a lot of questions about eye rigging, you know, pupils coming out of the eyes or not understanding blink states or stuff like that. So please use this project as a guide. If something isn't working, look at your setup, look at the most similar one of these faces to your particular setup and make sure everything is named and organized correctly and tagged the right way and all of that stuff. And you should be good to go. We would love to see what you create, so please use hashtag character animator when you are uploading, you know, videos to social media or whatever of your characters. We would love to see what you're making with this stuff. Or if nothing is working, everything is just falling apart and you are completely frustrated with how things are going, the best place to get individual help with your puppet is post a screenshot on the official character animator forums and we'll try to help you out as best we can. That's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching and have fun.